On the configuration screen, we have some tabs up here for controlling the configuration once it's done or to start fresh. If I've created a configuration, I can save it to a file. If I've created one in the past and want to reload it, I can load from one that's been saved to a hard drive and then continue to edit or to change it for a new application. Once I have a configuration done, I can click on this tab to see all the wiring for all the sensors for that setup. Once I have a configuration done, I can apply it to the station. And in this case here, I want to use this tab here to start fresh. So clear the configuration. Yes, I'm sure. In that case there, it starts off with a measurement interval of 15 minutes and a default name of H-Link. We also have these information tabs here that are used to give more instruction for each option. So this is the measurement interval on which the sensors will be measured. And station name, and I'm going to just change this to test. Now these tabs down here are what are used to actually configure the site. So we have sensors, alarms, and communications. So under sensors, I want to add a measurement. And in our application here, we're going to add a rain gauge. We want to monitor precipitation. So I'm going to come into rain, tipping buckets for rain, and a generic rain gauge. Here I have a slope of 0.01 for 0.01 inches per tip. The name of the measurement is going to be rain accumulation. This option here is used to decide if I want to reset the accumulator automatically or to just let it run. And I'm going to set it to reset on October 1st, which is a water year. Your processing is how the data is actually going to be stored. So in this case here, sample min 15 is minutes 15. And that's going to follow this rate right up here. If I expand this, it says my processing interval is 0 days. And if I look at this note here, it says if this is set to 0, then it will follow the measurement interval. So the default is 0 because in most cases, you're just going to be following this rate up here. Also on rain, the sample is the only processing you can do. On other measurements, you can do an average or a max and min. In most of the cases, you're just going to do a sample, an instantaneous value at that 15-minute mark. If I decided I didn't want to do this, I can always come over here and delete it, or I can delete the whole gauge. If I want to see where this sensor is wired in, I can come to this tab here and see the graphical view of where the wires will come from that rain gauge. Wire colors are black in this case because it's a generic sensor. I don't know what the colors of the wire will be. Over here is a tabular form or table form of the wiring for that sensor. And this is just the wiring for this one sensor. I can click on the name and shrink it down, minimize it. I also will want to add in a water level sensor. I'm going to add in a radar sensor. I'm going to add in a 475 on control port 1. Control port 1 and control port 2 can be used for SDI-12 and they're independent of each other. So I'm going to click on that. It comes up and it gives me the address. I'm going to change this to address 1. Measurement, I'm going to change this to simply just be stage. Okay, now notice down here on my processing, it defaults to the sample minutes 15. So it's going to track this up here again. If I actually do come up here and change this to 14, 13, 15, 10, notice how this has changed down here. So, and I'll explain that again. Notice that the interval here is 0. So whatever this is up here, this is going to track it. As long as that's 0, it's going to track. If I was to set this to something else, hard code it to something else, it would stay with whatever I chose to have it. Now this is a water level sensor. I could add in an average, max, or min. So for example, if I wanted to do an average, I would most likely change the rate here. So let's say I wanted to do an hour and set that to a 1 hour rate. Now what I'm going to get is 4 15-minute values averaged and reported once an hour. So 4 15-minute values averaged and stored in once an hour. If I don't want to do that, which is the case here, I'm going to come over here and just delete that. So my radar sensor is enabled, or is installed. I also know on this radar sensor I have other options with it. So the first option or first parameter out of that SDI-12 sensor is stage, but it has three other parameters that can come out of it for a total of four. So distance, sensor battery voltage, and an air code. So if this radar sensor was mounted on a bridge and several hundred feet away from the gauge, I may want to record the sensor voltage also. So I could easily bring that in and leave the processing to zero for an interval, sample 15, and I have that set up now. So now on my radar gauge, I have it doing water and battery voltage, water level and battery voltage coming out of that radar gauge. If I want to change the order in which these are logged, I can easily just come down here and click this arrow and it swaps them. The other thing I'd like to add now is an internal battery for diagnostics. So I'm going to bring the battery voltage in from the data logger. It's going to be logged every 15 minutes. I don't mind that name. I'm going to leave it as it is, and I'm done. So now I'm recording. I'm going to change that again. I got my water level, I got my rain, and I got my battery voltage. Now, if you noticed in here where we added the measurements and we did the radar gauge, often you're going to be using sensors that are from other manufacturers, and so you're going to have to use a generic. So what I'm going to do here is come in and add that same water level sensor, but do it as a generic sensor. So I'm going to come over here and delete this one and come into generic. SDI-12 on C1, address. So these setups are just very close to the same. I have to tell it now that it's generic, I'm not quite sure how to talk to it. It gives me a little bit more options here. So an M command from SDI-12, so a standard M command for the measurement. I don't know what this is. Under the 475, it said it was a stage. Since this is a generic, I'm not sure, so I'm going to have to tell it what I want the name to be. My processing here is still 15 minutes, so that's just what I want, and it has a slope of 1. Notice here that there's no offset. We will touch on that here in a little bit. If I wanted to bring in my battery voltage here, I know it's the third parameter, so I bring that in, and I tell it radar_volts. Offset of 0, a slope of 1. You have both of them here on this parameter. 15 minutes. So now I have a water level and a stage value both coming in. And I'm going to move that up. Oh, it looks like I deleted my rain gauge, so I'm going to go back and delete my radar. I'm going to pull back in my rain gauge. Shrink it down. Move that. So I have water level, rain, and battery voltage. So I have all my sensors set up at this point in time.